build a house where love can dwell and all can safely live. A place where saints and children tell how hearts learn to forgive. Built of hopes and dreams and visions, rock of faith and vault of grace. Here the love of Christ shall in divisions. All are welcome, all are welcome, all are welcome in this place. Let us build a house where prophets speak and words are strong and true. As one, we claim the faith of Jesus. All are welcome, all are welcome, all are welcome in this place. Let us build a house where love is found in water, wine, and wheat. Revealed in time and space, as we share in Christ the feast that frees us. All are welcome, all are welcome, all are welcome in this place. Let us build a house where hands will reach beyond the wood and stone to heal and strengthen, serve and teach and live the word they've known. Hear the outcast and the stranger, bear the image of God's face. Let us bring an end to fear and danger. All are welcome, all are welcome, all are welcome in this place. Let us build a house where all are named, their songs and visions heard, and loved and treasured, taught and claimed as words within the word. Built of tears and cries and laughter, prayers of faith and songs of grace. Let this house proclaim from floor to rafter, all are welcome, all are welcome, all are welcome in this place.
Join us in the sweet by and by.
There's a land that is fairer than day, and by faith we can see it afar. For the Father waits over the way to prepare us a dwelling place there in the sweet.
Sure.
In the sweet by and by. shall sing on that beautiful shore. The melodious song of the blessed, and our spirit shall sorrow no more. Not a sigh for the blessing of rest.
Sing with us.
In the sweet by and by, we shall meet on that beautiful shore. In the sweet by and by, we shall meet on that beautiful shore. To our bountiful Father above, we will offer our tribute of praise for the glorious gift of His love and the blessings that hallow our days.
One more time. Join us as we sing together. We'll understand it better by and by.
By and by, when the morning comes, when the saints of God are gathered home, we will tell the story how we've overcome, and we'll understand it better by and by. Trials dark on every hand, and we cannot understand all the ways that God would lead us to that blessed promised land. But He'll guide us with His eye, and we'll follow till we die, for we'll understand it better by and by.
Sing with us.
By and by, when the morning comes, when the saints of God are gathered home, we will tell the story how we've overcome, and we'll understand it better by and by.
That sounded great.
Temptation's hidden snares often take us unaware, and our hearts are made to bleed with some thoughtless word or deed. And we wonder why the test when we try to do our best. But we'll understand it better by and by.
Come on, let's go.
By and by, when the morning comes, when the saints of God are gathered home, we will tell the story how we've overcome, and we'll understand it better by and by.
One more time.
By and by, when the morning comes,
oh yeah,
when the saints of God are gathered home, tell the story how we've overcome, and we'll understand it better by and by.
For all the saints.
For all the saints.
Thank you. just beneath the rafters in a church of stone. Laid a stained glass window in the attic all alone. A work of art forgotten, a treasure thrown away. Taken from the sunlight, it was just a useless frame.
Good morning. Welcome to Worship at Leap of Faith Church. My name is Virgie Holbrook. Thank you for being here with me this morning. If you haven't already checked in on the comment column, would you do that now? Leave your name, the names of those who are worshiping with you. We so much appreciate having that information. Again, it's just right here in the comment column, your name and the names of those worshiping with you. If you prefer or need more privacy than that, you can text your name to 903-821-4505. If you'd like to support the ministry of Leap of Faith Church, that column is also helpful to you. To leave an offering, go all the way to the top. If you aren't receiving our newsletter, go all the way to the bottom of the comment column. Leave your email address there, and we'll be sure that you start getting our weekly newsletter. It comes out on Thursday evening. It'll hit your email box sometime in the evening on Thursday. We'd be glad to add you to that subscribers list. We have a few announcements this morning. If you'll be watching that newsletter for information about the month of November coming up, starting, my gosh, just next week. November is Thanks and Giving Month here at Leap of Faith, and you'll be able to read more about that in our newsletter. course, next Sunday starts too the Central Standard Time. We're losing daylight savings time next Sunday, so be aware of that. Our women's group will meet through November 3rd here in the sanctuary, Wednesdays at 1 p.m. Please remember that when you become ready to get back in the building, if you're here in the Texoma area, we worship in the sanctuary here at 11 a.m. every Sunday morning. For updated information about the church, it's mylofc.org. I sure do hope you enjoyed seeing that slideshow of the stained glass mural, the beginnings of that project and the completion of it to being hung and lit here in the sanctuary this morning at 11 o'clock. You know, that stained glass mural stood here in this building when it was Mr. L's restaurant, and it's the generous gift of Jean, who is Mr. L, Jean and Mary Ann Luscombe. If you know the Luscombes, or even if you don't, I hope when you see them that you'll take opportunity to thank them for this generous gift to Leap of Faith Church. We're grateful to Mary Ann Luscombe. She took most of those pictures that you saw that Brad put together into the slideshow so you could see how this mural came to be hung here at Leap of Faith. You know, if you're not quite ready to come back on Sunday morning, but you find yourself going down 1417 on any weekday, stop by and have a look. We'd love for you to see how the mural looks hanging here in the sanctuary. Well, again, thank you for coming to worship at Leap of Faith this morning. I hope you'll remember this. You are loved and you are wanted here at Leap of Faith Church. You are loved and you are wanted by our Lord Jesus Christ. Today is All Saints Sunday, and we're remembering and giving thanks for those in our lives who've brought us into a relationship with God through Jesus Christ. Those people, they are the faithful. Those people who have led us to God through Jesus, they are the saints, and we thank God for each one of them. I invite you to continue to worship with the music, the Leap of Faith Band.
Justice.
Here at Leap of Faith, we've adopted as our statement of faith that historic confession of the Christian faith, the Apostles' Creed. If you know it by memory, say it along with me. And if you're still learning it, the words are on the screen. I invite you to join me. I believe in God the Father Almighty, maker of heaven and earth, and in Jesus Christ, His only Son, our Lord, who was conceived by the Holy Spirit, born of the Virgin Mary, suffered under Pontius Pilate, was crucified, dead, and buried. The third day he arose from the dead. He ascended into heaven and sitteth at the right hand of God the Father Almighty. From thence he shall come to judge the quick and the dead. I believe in the Holy Spirit, the Holy Catholic Church, the communion of saints, the forgiveness of sins, the resurrection of the body, and the life everlasting. Amen. Now would you take a moment to name before God in the name of Jesus some of those things that have made rough spots in your relationship with God over the past week, things maybe that you've done that you wished you hadn't done, things that you omitted to do that wish you had done. Just name those honestly before God in Jesus' name. And now let's pray. Thank you, God. Thank you for those who've led us to follow Jesus. Thank you for those who've taught us to worship and serve you. They are the saints in our lives. We know, and you know too, that we've been slow to go where they've led. Forgive us, God, and help us step up to take our place in line with your saints. God, hear this prayer. Hear too our silent prayers of confession. Be sure that when we've confessed in the name of Jesus Christ, we're forgiven every single time. In the name of Jesus Christ, you're forgiven, and so am I. Amen. Joys and concerns this week. If you have something for the prayer list, that comment column is a great resource. You're welcome to list the names of those for whom you'd like prayers, either joys or concerns, here in the comment column. Or again, you can text those to me, 903-821-4505. We'll be happy to add your joys and your concerns to the prayer list. If you prefer confidentiality, the form at the bottom of the comment column gives you a place to list joys and concerns that you'd prefer to keep confidential. Here's what I have on the list, and of course, at any time, add yours to the comment column. We're praying for those who are ill, those who are injured, those who are suffering, those who are recovering from illness. We've been asked prayers for Jessica's mother-in-law, for Vicki, Aubrey, Bob, Rick, Shane, Dina, John, Jewel, Mary Ann, Mike, Paul's father, Lindy, Pat, Dassey, Jim, Zora, Mike, Ronnie, and Laurie. Pray, of course, today, as always, for those who serve our country in the military, especially these who are special here at Leap of Faith Church, Tyler, Jessica, Jordan, and Devin. Two birthdays this week. On November 3rd, Riley Smith has a birthday, and on November 5th, Dan Engelman has a birthday. Oh, how we wish that you were right here with us so we could put our arms around you and wish you a happy birthday, but you know that you're very much in our hearts, and we wish you all the best in the year ahead. Other joys, of course, Jean and Mary Ann, we are thanking God for their gift of the stained glass mural. We are thanking God for Steve and Cheryl Robinson, Phil Griffin, Wes Wadle. They came and worked for 2 days to hang that stained glass mural. We're thanking God for the Luscombs and Pat Courtney and Abigail Brown and Dave Potter. They were responsible for the interview that K-10 did on Thursday connected with that window. We're thanking God for Gina Monson. She sat in for Brad Nixon while he and Lissandra were on a 25th anniversary trip last weekend. Dave Monson came up during the week to touch up the floor with paint so that it looks fresh and brand new. Summer Holbrook, Maggie Helvey, Lysandra Nixon, Greg Holbrook, all of them are maintaining fellowship, leading and maintaining fellowship groups here at Leap of Faith. And today, as every single day, we thank God for the Leap of Faith band and for Brad and for Summer, who produce this worship service. If you have joys, if you have concerns, please let me know. I'd be happy to keep your joys and concerns in my prayers and add them to the concerns and joys of the church. And now let's pray. As we begin that prayer, I remind you that today we're remembering our ancestors in the faith, those whose stories we study in the Old and New Testaments. Today on this All Saints Sunday, we're remembering the ministers and pastors and priests, those who have taught us to follow Jesus. Today, All Saints Sunday, we're remembering friends and neighbors whose examples of faithfulness have encouraged us to be faithful too. We're remembering today parents and grandparents and aunts and uncles, those who've gone before us in our lifetime to show us the way. Today, we're remembering children and grandchildren. We're remembering brothers and sisters, husbands and wives, whose lives here among us ended much too soon, but in the light of God's love will go on eternally. We're lifting up to God today the names of those dear to Leap of Faith friends and members, those who in just this past year have passed from this life into life eternal. We are secure in the faith that they are with God now and forever. We're celebrating the lives of those whose names we'll read shortly. And if you have someone who you'd like to remember on this All Saints Sunday, you're welcome to add their name over here in the comment column. Let's pray. Thank you, God. Thank you, God, for all who have gone on to join you beyond this life. We trust your promise of new life in Christ and know that you're with us, God. You are with us in grief and in celebration. You never leave us alone. In the name of Jesus, in whom love lives forever, we pray now in the way that he's taught us. Our Father who art in heaven, hallowed be thy name. Thy kingdom come, thy will be done, on earth as it is in heaven. Give us this day our daily bread. Forgive us our trespasses, as we forgive those who trespass against us. And lead us not into temptation, but deliver us from evil. For thine is the kingdom, and the power, and the glory forever. Amen. And now I share with you the names of those dear to Leap of Faith members and friends who have gone on to glory in the year just past. Jonna Brown's father, John Brown, Gina Monson's uncle, Ralph Brown, Jennifer West's sister, Marie Jones, Jessica Brown's dad, Steve Carter, Jessica Brown's uncle, Daryl Fields, Ronnie Fralick's mother, Laverne Fralick's, Pam Foreman's mother, Margie Rogers, Lisa Brockmeyer's former husband, Dwayne Figg, Tom Gewen's son, Brady Gewen's, Maggie Helvey's nephew, David Cumming, Maggie Helvey's friend, Linda Beasley, and her friend, Karen Gibson, Pat Courtney's husband, Ralph Courtney, Leap of Faith member, Mary Sims, Brenda Orgel's uncle, Leonard Branham, Lysandra Nixon's aunt, Wanda Jones, Pam Griffin's father, Jimmy Wright, Amy Zimmerman's grandmother, Gina Monson's sister, Chris Hicks, Karen Lamb's father, Don Thacker, Norma Coates' grandson-in-law, Joey Sanchez, Maggie Helvey's sister, Claire Cumming, Dan and Shirley Engelman's friend, Mike Thompson, and Brad Nixon's cousin, Nick Cox. We're thanking God on this All Saints Sunday for each one of these lives. Today, our Bible lesson continues in book of Acts, the Acts of the Apostles in the New Testament. You'll want to read chapters 24, 25, and 26, but I'm reading you just a few verses from those chapters, Acts 25, verse 14, and then verses 18 and 19. They go like this. Since they were spending many days in Caesarea, Festus discussed Paul's case with the king. He said, "There's a man here whom Felix left as prisoner. When I went to Jerusalem, the chief priests and the elders of the Jews brought charges against him and asked that he be condemned. When his accusers got up to speak, they did not charge him with any of the crimes I had expected. Instead, they had some points of dispute with him about their own religion and about a dead man named Jesus, who Paul claimed was alive." And then from Acts chapter 26, verses 22b through 23, Paul said to the king, "I am saying nothing beyond what the prophets and Moses said would happen, that the Messiah would suffer, and as the first to rise from the dead would bring the message of light to his own people and to the Gentiles." I ask God to bless this reading of God's word. I'm going to put you on the spot today. Today I am going to put you on the spot. Today I have three questions for you. You don't have to put the answer in the comment column. You don't have to answer out loud, except just there in the privacy of your own home, your own place of worship. But I do ask you to be honest with yourself about the answers to these three questions. So here are the questions. Do you believe that God gives life? Do you believe that God gives life? I expect that most of us would say yes. I expect that you probably would say yes. Most everyone who believes in God believes that God gives life. The next question, do you believe that God gave Jesus life after death? Do you believe that God raised Jesus bodily and historically to new life? Not metaphorically, not literally, not as a vision. Do you believe? Do you believe that God raised Jesus bodily and historically at a particular point in history to new life? I asked someone who's a lifelong committed Christian this question this week, and after some thought, the answer was maybe. I have to appreciate that kind of honesty. I think that a lot of us might answer that question maybe, particularly if we were feeling certain that our answer wasn't going to be judged. So, do you believe that? Do you believe that God gave Jesus life, new life, raising his body from death at a particular point in history? And now one last question. Do you believe that God can raise, do you believe that God will raise the dead? Just the ordinary me and you. Do you believe that God will raise us to new life? Almost every single one of us, I imagine, is hoping and hoping and hoping that God can and will raise the dead, will raise us and will raise those we love to new life after we die. I also imagine that almost every single one of us, especially in our darkest hours, does wonder how this can possibly be true, God raising even the deadest of the dead to new life. Can God really do that? Do you believe God can really do that? This is a particularly apt question to consider, though, on this Sunday of all Sundays, All Saints Sunday, the day each year when we remember those who have died to this life and been raised, so we say, to new life in the year just past. As it happens, this is the very question that was causing so much trouble for Paul in our Bible story today. Here's what's happening. You might remember that as we get close to wrapping up our look at how the church spread in the early days and years after it was started by the power of the Holy Spirit at Pentecost, now we've worked our way up to the role of church planter, Paul. You might remember that in three separate trips, Paul traveled all around the eastern end of the Mediterranean, traveled around Asia Minor and into Greece, starting churches, spreading the gospel, until Paul finally made the decision after 2 years spent in Ephesus that he'd leave Ephesus there in Turkey and return to Jerusalem, and from Jerusalem go on to Rome. He felt, we surmised, that he was called to preach the gospel there in Rome. When Paul gets to Jerusalem, all kinds of trouble breaks out against him, trouble that seems to be leading to Paul's certain death. Finally, Paul is hauled out of Jerusalem in chains, taken to the town of Caesarea, where he's held there captive awaiting trial. Now, remember the issue. Remember what the trouble is. It's largely theological in nature, having to do with concerns regarding the resurrection. This part of Paul's story, it's told in chapters 24, 25, and 26 of Acts, and I encourage you to get your Bible today and read those three chapters, 24, 25, and 26. Read them for yourself. But by way of summary, though, Paul is finally tried before Governor Felix, allegedly because Paul is a troublemaker stirring up riots among the Jews. Paul defends himself. He defends himself as a faithful Jew and as a follower of Christ, a follower of Christ who believes in the resurrection. Governor Felix leaves Paul in prison for 2 long years until finally Governor Felix is succeeded by Governor Festus, and Paul again is brought to trial. Well, Paul again defends himself as having done nothing against the law of the Jews or against the temple or against the Caesar. Finally, Paul demands his rights as a citizen of Rome and appeals his case to Caesar. And in the end, it's decided. Paul is going to go to Rome. We'll hear more about that next Sunday. But first, let's talk a little bit about what this part of Paul's story, or more precisely, Paul's claim that got him in so much trouble, that claim that I read to you earlier. Let's talk just now about what that claim that Paul made has to do with you, what it has to do with me. Paul's claim, of course, is this. Paul said, I am saying nothing beyond what the prophets and Moses said would happen, that Christ would suffer and as first to rise from the dead would proclaim light to his own people and to the Gentiles. In other words, Paul was saying that Jesus really died, that Christ really arose, and because of him, so will we, you. And me. You know, for me, the amazing thing about this is that we can experience something of the truth of this ultimate claim in the ordinary living out of our lives here and now. I've experienced, and I bet you have too, when we give up something that we want for someone else's good, we find ourselves invariably born into a new life. When we die out of love to self-interest for the good of another, we are born into a new life. It's a principle. It works. But what about after we really and truly die? What about after we physically die? We've all heard stories, I imagine, like the one that I read this week about Nicole Foster. As some of you know, our family has watched a lot of volleyball this fall with 2 granddaughters playing on 2 teams. So I was especially interested in Nicole Foster's story. It seems that Nicole Foster was stillborn. When she was born, she had no heartbeat. When she was born, she wasn't breathing. At birth, her heart wasn't working, and neither were her lungs. The medical team in that delivery room, they were able to resuscitate her, but at 2 days old, Nicole Foster was on a ventilator with no detectable brain activity. Her parents were told that in the unlikely event she survived, she would likely live out her life in a vegetative state. But Nicole did survive, and there's really no explanation for how things turned around for her. Today, while Nicole is completely deaf in one ear and profoundly deaf in the other, with the cochlear implant and expert lip reading skills, Nicole communicates just fine. What Nicole also does just fine, what Nicole also does much better than just fine, is play volleyball for Prestonwood Christian School in Plano, which has the best high school volleyball team in the Dallas area. And this coming May, Nicole will represent the United States as the youngest member of the USA Deaf Women's Volleyball Team at the Deaflympics in Brazil. It turns out that Nicole, the one who was born dead at birth, is a very, very, very good volleyball player, high jumping, hard hitting, and oh so very accurate. And Nicole was apparently dead at birth. Was she resurrected? Well, it beats me. But whatever happened to Nicole, she, of course, is not absolute proof of resurrection, because I've stood over a lot of deathbeds. I've stood over a lot of caskets. I've stood over a lot of grave sites, and I have never, ever seen one dead body in them come back to life. Still and all, if we believe in a God who gives life, why should it be hard to believe in a God who somehow, some way, gives life even to the dead? Why wouldn't a God who loves life, who gives life, keep on giving it and giving it and giving it? I know that it can require not just a leap of faith, but also a broad jump of faith. But still in all, I invite you on this All Saints Sunday to go ahead and make that leap, make that jump, and decide to believe at your foundation, at your very core, that God really does work in just that way. I invite you on this All Saints Sunday to affirm with the Apostle Paul, "I am saying nothing beyond what the prophets and Moses said would happen, that Christ would suffer, and as the first to rise from the dead, would proclaim light to his own people and to the Gentiles." In other words, Jesus really died. In other words, Christ really arose. And because of him, so will we. Really. Really. Amen. Thank you. Thank you for coming to worship on this All Saints Sunday. It's good to spend this time with you. If you came late and haven't put your name in the column there, I'd appreciate it if you'd take the opportunity to do that now. If you're ready to join us as a member, if you're not yet a member and you'd like to do that, give me a call, 903-821-4505. It would be the first time that I've received a new member over the phone. If you'd like to do it that way, or if you would like to become a member in some other way, some other more immediate way, I would be very glad to arrange that. I'd like to be your pastor. I'd love for Leap of Faith to be your church. If that's your intention, be sure to let me know. If you want to support the ministry of Leap of Faith Church, here in the comment column, go all the way to the top. There's a giving button there. You haven't yet left your name in the comments and would like to couple that with a request for our newsletter, go all the way to the bottom of the column. There's a place to leave your email address, and we'll be happy to add you to our email newsletter each Thursday evening. When the service is over, you can go to the Leap of Faith Church Facebook page, like that page, and it's a good way to keep up with all that's going on at the church. And I remind you that we have a website, mylofc.org. Please stick around when the service is over. Enjoy the music of the Leap of Faith band. And now, will you remember this? Will you go follow as Jesus leads? Will you take others by the hand and lead them along the way too? Take others by the hand and invite them to come along with you to Jesus, to the Lord of love. Amen. Go in peace, my friends. Go in peace.
I'm so glad you're here at Leap of Faith Church. I hope you'll invite your friends as we continue to worship. Draw the circle wide.
Draw the circle wide. Draw it wider still. Let this be our song. No one stands alone, standing side by side. Circle wide.
From the still point of the circle, run you all creation turns. Nothing lost but held forever in God's gracious arms.
Sing with me.
Circle wide.
draw the circle wide, draw it wider still. Let this be our song, no one stands alone, standing side by side, draw the circle.
Dreams we dream be larger than we've ever dreamed before. Let the dream of Christ be in us, open every door. Draw the circle wide, draw it wider still. Let this be our song, no one stands standing side by side. Draw the circle wide, draw the circle wide, draw it wider still. Let this be our song, no one stands alone, standing side by side.